So, so we are looking at default reasoning, and in particular we are looking at circumscription. So, remember that when we say circumscription, we say that given a knowledge base phi and given a predicate p, we can define a new knowledge base in which the extent of the predicate p is minimized, and we will try to formalize this notion today. Essentially, we will define a notion of minimal entailment. So, a knowledge base under circumscription, we will use this symbol, entails a formula alpha if alpha is 2 in all minimal models. So, we will have the notion of minimal models here. If you remember, the standard notion of entailment says that a knowledge base KB entails a formula alpha if whenever, if in any interpretation or where KB is true, or in every model of KB alpha is true essentially. But now we are not insisting on every model, we are saying only on minimal models essentially, which means that certain models, certain interpretations which are models, we will not be bothered about if they are not minimal models in some sense essentially, and we will formalize this notion in a couple of minutes. And what do we mean by minimal models or minimal interpretations is that the extent of certain predicates which we have identified in circumscription, their extent has to be as small as possible essentially. So, we can actually define circumscription, we will give a couple of definitions there from different sources. So, one is that a circumscription of a knowledge base with respect to a predicate p is the knowledge base and the fact that there does not exist a q. So, see here that we are moving away from first order logic into what some people call a second order logic, because we are talking about quantifiers over predicates essentially, where q is a predicate such that phi q is true, and I will define this in a moment, and q is less than p, this also we will define in a moment. So, let me circumscribe this definition, and that is basically the idea of circumscription, that certain predicates we circumscribe essentially. What is the meaning of these things? This means that I have replaced p with q, every occurrence of p in my knowledge base I have replaced with q, another predicate. So, the only way p and q are different is basically if you think of them as relations over which elements belong to those relations, or which individuals belong to those relations essentially. Then we can define q is less than or equal to p if this is true, that for all x q x implies p x. Here we are not talking explicitly about extension, but we are talking it in terms of different predicates essentially. So, q is a predicate which says that whenever q is true, p is true. So, you can think of, alternatively we can think of this as saying that the interpretation of q under whichever interpretation we are looking at is a subset of the interpretation of P, which is also what we mean by the this thing essentially. We say that Q is equal to P if for all x Q x is equivalent to P x. Remember that equivalent is both way implication. The thing to observe is that on the left hand side we are talking about predicate names essentially. So, we are not in first order logic, you can use equality for terms essentially. You can say Modi is equal to prime minister of India, things like that, but here we are talking of predicates which are basically sets. Remember that for at least unary predicates are sets and binary predicates are sets of subsets of cross products and so on. And we can define Q less than P if Q less than equal to P and Q not equal to P exactly. So, just think a little bit carefully about what are we saying here. That the definition of circumscription of a knowledge base with respect to a predicate P is the knowledge base as long as, because we have said and there does not exist a Q, such that if I were to substitute Q for P, the knowledge base would be true and Q is less than P. We have defined an order relations between predicates, and the order relation is basically a subset relation in the domain essentially. The Q is a has a smaller extent than P essentially. The number of elements in Q is less than the number of elements in P, in the image of Q is less than the elements of image of key P essentially. So, there is an alternative definition which is given in the book Brackman and Levesk. This says that we can define an interpretation I 1 is less than or equal to interpretation I 2, and this is with respect to a set P of predicates, because we it is not necessary that we circumscribe only one predicate, we can circumscribe a set of predicates if for every P belongs to this set P, the image of in the first interpretation is a subset of image of P in the second interpretation. So, you can see there is a there is only a subtle difference between the two ways. What I have written in red is not talking about interpretations explicitly, but it is saying that there is another predicate called Q, but Q implies P essentially, and which means that everything that is in Q is in P essentially. Here we are not talking about a separate predicate, we are not renaming the predicate, we are saying the predicate is the same, but the interpretation is different. So, in one interpretation I 1 the image of P would be the set which of elements which belong to P is a subset in the second interpretation I 2 essentially. So, it is basically a subset of the original set that we are trying to minimize essentially. So, another in this definition we say that a knowledge base KB entails, and again we are giving an alternative definition of minimal entailment. I have already given you one definition which is there for circumscription, here it is just in different words. If for every interpretation I such that the knowledge base entails, sorry, the interpretation entails the knowledge base, or the knowledge base is true under that interpretation. Either one of the following should be true, that in that interpretation the formula alpha is true. Now, this is the old notion of entailment we had talked about. The normal entailment simply said that a knowledge base entails alpha if for every interpretation I, if the knowledge base is true, alpha must be true in that interpretation. But as we said, in circumscription we are talking about something called minimal entailment, which means that we are not going to look at every interpretation, or we are not insisting that for every model the alpha must be true, but only for certain models which are minimal in some sense, which we have already described, but here is another way of describing it. So, the second thing is that second part, or there is another interpretation I prime such that it is smaller I so maybe I should have defined that. We say that I 1 is smaller than I 2 if I 1 is smaller than or equal to I 2, because we are talking about sets and I 2 is not smaller than or equal to I 1. So, once we define smaller than or equal to, we can define smaller. So, that is basically a partial order thing essentially, and this is a little bit, it takes a bit of time to digest. And we will see an example pretty soon. So, let us first discuss what this definition is saying. We are saying that a knowledge base KB minimally entails alpha, or under minimal entailment it alpha, either for every interpretation in which the knowledge base is true, alpha is true, which is a normal entailment, or we can ignore a certain interpretation I if there is a smaller interpretation in which the knowledge base is true. Then we can ignore So, if there exists an I prime which is smaller than I, then do not bother about whether the whether in that I the knowledge base is true or not essentially. So, let us look at an example and hopefully that will make things clearer. So, here is another way of saying it, if alpha is true in all KB. So, this minimal is with respect to the relation that we have defined essentially, the less than relation, that an interpretation is less than another interpretation if it has fewer elements essentially, or if its image is a subset of the other interpretation essentially. So, we can now say that circumscription in under circumscription a knowledge base entails alpha under circumscription or minimal entailment if alpha is true in all minimal models of the knowledge base essentially. So, let us look at this example that we were looking at of this birds flying, and the KB is as follows. So, I will just use the first letters of those predicates for all x, bird x implies flies x, sorry, not abnormal x implies flies x. So, f is for flies and b is for bird, then bird I will use t for Tweety and c for chili, and they are not equal and not flies chili. That's a knowledge base that we have. Basically, the first statement says that birds fly normally, that normal birds fly, or normally birds fly. The second statement says Tweety is a bird, T is Tweety. The third statement says Chili C is a bird. They are not the same, and we know that Chili cannot fly essentially. And we have identified that this abnormality predicate is this predicate AB essentially. So, and there is a relation between not flying and this thing. So, if you are abnormal, you cannot fly. You can see that this is equivalent to saying that bird x and not flies x implies abnormal x. You can see that logically they are equivalent essentially. It is like the contrapositive in this thing. So, not abnormal implies flies, and not flies implies abnormal essentially. So, let us construct the models. And abnormality predicate is the only one that we are going to play around with. The other predicates have extents as given to us. We know that Tweety is a bird, we are not going to modify that, and that Chili is a bird, and so on and so forth exactly. So, the extent of the predicate bird we know, the extent of flies we know, the Chili is not in flies. So, what do we mean by that? We mean that if we take the image of the predicate flies, then Chili is not present in that. We want to find out whether Tweety can be present in that or not. That is a question of whether Tweety can fly or not essentially. So, you can think of four models. And there is a relation between them, and the relation is less than. In the smallest model, both are not abnormal, which is equivalent to saying that if I were to only list the abnormal birds, I would not list anything in that essentially. Maybe I should do that in parallel here. When I list only the abnormal predicates, then I do not list anything there. Then in the largest model, both are abnormal. Then there are two intermediate models where one of the birds is abnormal. So, here let us say Chili is not abnormal and AB is abnormal and Tweety is abnormal. Here Tweety is not abnormal and Chili is abnormal. So, we have four interpretations for this thing. So, if I were to write this here, I would simply write A B T A B C. So, in maybe the less than relation is more obvious in the red colored diagram, because you can see that it has smaller and smaller elements as you go down from top to down essentially. Okay. Now, you can see that this interpretation does not entail the knowledge base. Why is that? Because this interpretation says that the chili is not abnormal essentially, whereas we know that chili is abnormal essentially. That is given to us because we have been given that chili cannot fly, and therefore we know the chili is abnormal. So, this is not a model essentially. So, we can actually cross it out essentially. Likewise, the model which says that Tweety is abnormal and Chili is not abnormal also does not entail the knowledge base, for the same reason, because we know that Chili is abnormal, and therefore you can say it is not a model essentially. Now, the other two, they actually entail the knowledge base. So, that is the thing about entailment. K B entails alpha if first of all K B should be true in the knowledge base, in the interpretation, and then in that interpretation alpha should be true essentially. So, we have actually two models. So, we have these two models. Or two interpretations. In one interpretation, so these are not models. So you can actually, so there are two models. In one model, Chili is abnormal, and in the other model, both Tweety and Chili are abnormal essentially. Now, if you look at the definition that we just gave about entailment. So, if you read at the bottom of this slide, a knowledge base entails alpha if for every interpretation I such that I is a model, or I entails, or K B is true in I, either alpha must be true or there must exist a smaller interpretation which is also a model essentially. So, what is the query? Our query is flies Tweety, or in other words, does the knowledge base entail this flies Tweety. So, we are looking at all those interpretations, all those models in which the knowledge base is true. So, by definition a model is an interpretation in which the knowledge base is true. And in this case, of the four possibilities, and we are only allowed to play around with this abnormality predicate, the other predicates we do not play around with. So, of the four possible interpretations, two are not models at all, because they say that Chili is not abnormal, whereas we know that Chili cannot fly, and so therefore Chili is abnormal. So, two are not models at all. Of the two remaining which are models, you can see that in the smaller model, that definition that because Tweety is not abnormal. So, if you look at the if you look at what we have written in the blue, this part is important, that Tweety is not abnormal. So, in this model or in this interpretation, so let's give them names essentially. So, if this interpretation is I 1, I 1, then you can see that in I 1 V t is not abnormal. In all interpretations V t is a bird, and therefore, in I 1 so you can see that I 1 entails bird, sorry not bird, flies V t. Because in the diagram on the left explicitly we have written that not abnormal P t is true, and the formula that we are using is that if x is a bird and x is not abnormal then x can fly. So, we so fly is V t is entailed in I 1 essentially. Let us call this I 0. What about I 0? I 0 we do not bother whether it entails flies V t or not. Why? Is ignored because I 1 is less than I 0 and I 1 So, there were two clauses, either the formula that we are trying to prove must be entailed in the interpretation or there must be a smaller interpretation in which the knowledge base is true. As long as the knowledge base is true we are fine, and we can see here that the knowledge base is true in this smaller interpretation. So, we can just ignore this. So, I am just trying to state the same thing in many different ways essentially. At the top of this slide we have written that the minimal entailment says that alpha is true in all minimal models. Now, you can see that I 0 is not a minimal model because there is a smaller model which is I 1, smaller in the sense of the size of the abnormality predicate, the image of the model. So, by that definition there are only two models, and as long as the formula is true in the smaller model we are fine. If there were other minimal models then the formula better had be true in that as well, but in this example there are only two. Maybe you can try to extend it with some few more birds and try to work it out yourself and see essentially. So, one way of saying this is that it must be true in all minimal models. Another way of saying is true is that for every interpretation or for every model either the entailment must hold, which means the formula flies V t must be true, or there must exist a smaller model. That is the definition that we gave from, that is the definition given in Blackman and Levesque essentially. So, there are two models, in one model the entailment holds, for the other model there exists a smaller model, which means that for this knowledge base we can infer that V t can fly, and that is circumscription essentially. So, we will stop here. In the next class we will revisit this, we will start with this definition again, and then we will try to see what are the difficulties or what are the advantages. So, I will let you digest this and come back. I know that it takes a little bit of time to get a hang of circumscription essentially, and we will discuss the pros and cons. We will see that it is better than closed world assumption, but it has its own problems also essentially.